Hi, it's Elisa with Scripts and Scribes. We are at the Writers Guild Foundation Screenwriting Symposium, and we get to speak with Evan Daugherty, which is a huge honor because you've done a lot of really, really big, great things in a very short amount of time. You did Snow White and the Huntsman, Divergent, other huge projects.
Yep.
So congratulations.
Thank you. They keep me busy.
I would imagine.
Yes.
I guess where I'd like to start is that it has been a pretty short amount of time since everything kind of happened. But it was also a very long process before everything happened, right? So you graduated school.
Yes.
And you had a manager that was interested?
Yes, that's right. Right after I got out of NYU in 2004.
Yep.
And using Snow White, I did get, it's the term they use now, is hip pocketed.
Right.
By a manager. I thought that was going to be the thing that instantly got me all the meetings and got jobs. And it was a good process. We worked on the script together for maybe 6 months.
Mm-hmm.
And then he just sort of stopped returning calls. So, so when it's funny because people have said like it's quick and it's fast. And it has been, but it's all relative, I guess.
You know?
And
completely.
It certainly hasn't felt particularly fast, especially because, from when I got out of school to when I got my second manager, mm-hmm. the one I still have today, an agent at my first job, it was like 4 or 5 years, which is obviously some people have 10 lean years, some people have 15, some people have all lean years. So it's great that it was only 5 years. But, look, it's like, 5 years of really beating my head against the wall trying to figure out how you get in to this world. There's a lot of false starts. There's a lot of twists and turns. And there isn't really, there's not some watershed moment where everything is figured out. There's been a lot of good moments. There's like getting the manager that I'm still with was a big moment. Getting that agent was a big moment. It took me another year, though, of even having an agent or manager to get to the place where Snow White sold. So I had a couple of really small jobs that were not high priority for the mm-hmm. studio, paid scale.
Mm-hmm.
Once I paid agents, managers, et cetera, barely had enough money for food and rent mm-hmm. in Los Angeles. So it's that thing of you're never, there's not some singular moment where it all clicks. There's a lot of great, plateaus or great moments or milestones along the way. And, selling Snow White was one of them. Having it actually get made was one of them. Having it do well was one of them. But it's just kind of that, it's been a steady build, not one sudden moment.
So I guess with that, I'd like to ask first, what did you do during those leaner times or those times where maybe you felt like things were definitely not going as well, or you had some setbacks, major disappointments that were happening? What did you do to keep yourself proactive, to keep yourself fighting for what you wanted to do rather than just throwing it up, throwing the towel in, so to say?
It's hard. I did, the cliched answer is what I tried to do to keep saying, which is to keep writing stuff,
mm-hmm.
keep writing new material. And a lot of that stuff is terrible and it won't see the light of day. It does help kind of keep you going, and it helps you get hopefully better mm-hmm. at what you're doing. One of the things I mentioned in the panel was the idea that you really, in my opinion, don't want to have only one script that you keep rewriting again and again. Now, I'm going to like play devil's advocate and say that this one of the first scripts I ever wrote and that I kept rewriting was Snow White. I wrote that when I was 20 years old, mm-hmm. and it took 10 years for it to get made. But I wrote many different scripts between the first draft of Snow White
mm-hmm.
and the draft of Snow White that sold, and learned a lot in the process. Yeah. So that's a big part of it. Another part is that for the first part of those sort of lean years, I was writing, this is also somewhat cliched advice, but it's true, I was writing very much for exactly what I thought Hollywood was wanting. Whether it's big tent poles and the kind of movies I write now, but I was writing them in a kind of down the middle, straight ahead mm-hmm. way, thinking that that's what would get, mm-hmm. Attention. I didn't start having success, whether it's with the new manager or winning contests, until I put that aside and said, well, I have a moment here in my life where I can write anything that I want. There's not studio executives telling me what to do. There's not producers telling me what to do. I can write anything. So I kind of like divorced myself from those thoughts about trying to please studios and wrote something that was like, I would say, more personal, more idiosyncratic, a little more outside the box. And that was the script that got me that like I won a contest and then got me a manager and got me an agent. It was on the blacklist.
You so got all that from Shrapnel, right?
Shrapnel, it was called. Yep. So that idea of sort of it's like life's what happens when you're making other plans, like putting aside, you know, any desire to impress someone or and focusing on what you really want to do, because that's the thing that conversely will get people to pay attention.
I love how honest that answer is. And I-